Welcome to Storyflix. In this video, we will explain Freehold, an unusual film about a shady real estate agent that has no idea that he's acquired a hidden houseguest. Remaining hidden, the guest eats his food, wears his clothes, and even uses his toothbrush. What was the purpose of the intruder in his apartment? Let's find out on Freehold. Freehold begins in an apartment. A man named Hussein wakes up from sleep and starts doing his morning activities. He showered, changed clothes, and had breakfast. Hussein seems like an office worker who has a good career. That's why he was able to make a living and live in a comfortable apartment. Unfortunately, Hussein was completely unaware that someone else was living in his apartment. Every morning, a man named Orlan starts his activities like Hussein. He cleaned his mouth with mouthwash and brushed his teeth with Hussein's toothbrush. He also wiped his body with Hussein's towel. Orlan then had breakfast. This morning he wanted to eat cereal for breakfast by adding milk from Hussein's refrigerator. He was so enjoying his freedom in Hussein's apartment that he even took a nap in his bed. In the afternoon, Hussein, who came home from work all day, got a call from his girlfriend, Mel. It turns out Mel was going to visit his apartment in 2 days, and she asked Hussein to pick her up at the airport. Hussein, who was tired from working all day, immediately fell asleep. That's when Orlan used to get out of hiding. By moving quietly between Hussein's deep sleep, Orlan began to do activities and enjoy every facility in that apartment. But the longer he stayed in Hussein's apartment, the more Orlan's behavior started to get worse. Now he started changing the alarm, hoping that Hussein would wake up late. And sure enough, the following day, Hussein had to hurry because he was late for work. Orlan, who was alone in the apartment, got into action again. He had milk for his breakfast. He even put tap water in a milk bottle. But not only that, Orlan wanted Hussein to be late to pick up Mel, so he changed the reminder written on the refrigerator door. In that apartment, Orlan was alone, so he often felt lonely. Outside the window, there were two pigeons who had always been his friends. Every day, Orlan always feed the two pigeons. The rest of his time was spent having fun and using all of Hussein's equipment. Hussein, who came home from work, still looks busy selling some properties. It turns out he worked as a real estate agent. But that night, he was seen busy cleaning his kitchen. Moreover, the milk in the refrigerator had gone stale because of Orlan's actions. Because he was tired of working all day and busy cleaning his apartment, Hussein immediately fell asleep. In the middle of Hussein's deep sleep, Orlan reappeared and started checking Hussein's wallet. There he found his credit card. Orlan wrote down all the important information from Hussein's credit card. He was sure that the credit card would be of use to him one day. The next day, Hussein woke up from his sleep and started getting ready to start the day. But the difference is, today is Saturday, so he doesn't go to the office to work. Hussein was also seen busy cleaning his entire apartment. Then Mel called and was angry because his had not yet picked her up at the airport, even though she had been waiting for a long time. He then immediately went to pick up Mel. That's when Orlan used to get out of his hiding place and began to put his spit into Hussein's mouthwash. He even wore Hussein's socks and underwear that had just been washed. Orlan then lures the two pigeons into the apartment by sprinkling some breadcrumbs. Sure enough, the pigeon made a fuss, and Mel became hysterical. Orlan tried hard to make Mel not feel at home in the apartment. The two pigeons began to poop and littered the entire apartment. Now Orlan must hide longer, because there are two people in the apartment. Mel could not find any food in Hussein's apartment, even though Hussein was very sure that he had already stocked up on food. Mel then went shopping for Hussein. That night, as a form of apology, Hussein took Mel out for dinner at a fancy restaurant. Realizing the empty apartment, Orlan came out again from his hiding place and finished Mel's bath soap. He even shaved his armpits with Hussein's razor. Since Hussein and Mel were having fancy eating at the restaurant, Orlan wanted to feel the same way. He started cooking spaghetti and enjoyed his time in the apartment as if it were the owner. Not only that, Orlan started throwing Hussein's jewelry down the toilet and cutting his tie. He also used Hussein's mouthwash, but this time he put the liquid from his snot into the mouthwash bottle. Now he's starting to replace Mel and Hussein's soap with a floor cleaner. The next day, Hussein began to get ready to go out with Mel. He started gargling with mouthwash and a toothbrush that had been mixed with Orlan's spit. But he was so shocked when he couldn't find his earrings. His tie had even been cut. When Hussein and Mel were gone, Orlin reappeared and started to do his actions. Now he uses Mel's laptop to access porn sites. He even grabbed Mel's underwear and wiped the snot from his nose. Of course, his goal was achieved. Now Mel and Hussein are fighting, and Mel is starting to get disgusted with all of Hussein's behavior, which he thinks is starting to be abnormal. That night when Hussein and Mel were fast asleep, Orlin woke up and started to poop. But he deliberately did not flush it. Mel, who found Orlin's poop, was disgusted and angry. Hussein and Mel then start fighting and blaming each other. Finally, Mel could not stand Hussein anymore and decided to leave and end their relationship. Realizing that Mel had left the apartment made Orlin happy. He started to move on. Now he started clipping his toenails and putting them under Hussein's pillow. Orlin then purposely threw Hussein's cutlery into the toilet and peed on it. After that, he put them back in their place. Hussein, who had just returned from work, was completely oblivious to what Orlin had done all day. But he started to feel itchy rashes on his skin because he had been bathing with floor cleaning soap all this time. After bathing, Hussein used the filthy spoon to stir up the medicine and went to bed. But instead, he smelled a pungent smell from underneath his pillow. It turns out there he found Orlin's dirty toenails. Hussein suspected it was Mel's doing. The following day before Hussein woke up, Orlin put his earwax into Hussein's vitamins. He also put his snot into the mouthwash and used Hussein's toothbrush to clean his ears. Hussein, who doesn't know, used up all his dirty toiletries and started to get sick. That night he woke up with an itchy body. He then went to the kitchen. Orlin was so shocked and immediately hid on a cupboard. Fortunately, Hussein was seriously ill at the time and was still not aware of Orlin's presence in his apartment. When Hussein was asleep in his sleep, Orlin strikes again. Now he deleted all of Hussein's scheduled meetings and threw away all his toilet paper. Hussein was getting sicker and suffering so much. He didn't even come to work the next day. Hussein began to be confused by all the oddities in his apartment until two couriers delivered a freezer. Hussein was pretty sure he didn't buy the freezer. Strangely, the seller said that Hussein bought the freezer using his credit card. And we can tell if it was Orlin who purchased the freezer using Hussein's credit card. Every day Orlin's actions are getting to the next level. He took Hussein's cell phone and took a picture of his dick. The photo was then sent to his boss. And sure enough, his boss came and was furious with Hussein's photo. Hussein was even fired right then and there. After his boss left, Hussein began to feel strange in his apartment because suddenly, the water in the faucet ran by itself. Hussein began to believe that he wasn't the only one in his apartment. It looks like Orlin deliberately showed signs of his presence in the apartment. Hussein started to get suspicious, then checked the whole apartment, but he couldn't find Orlin. Finally, Hussein called a man and installed additional locks on his apartment door. But of course, the keys and locks were useless because Orlin was already in his apartment. Orlin then disturbs Hussein, who is sleeping. But still, Hussein could not find the whereabouts of Orlin in his apartment. Hussein began not to stand the condition of his skin that was getting itchy. Having no job, he spent all his time at home lazing around and snacking all day long. Because he was running out of money, he began stocking up on frozen food at his house. One day, while on his bed, Hussein finally realized the existence of Orlin, who was hiding under his bed. The two then got into an argument. Orlin started to tell Hussein the reason he had been in his apartment all this time. It turned out that Orlin was a former buyer of one of the properties that Hussein sold. He was disappointed because Hussein had deceived him. Hussein's actions caused Orlin and his girlfriend to become homeless. At that time, his girlfriend was pregnant. Finally, his girlfriend decided to go and leave him. That's why Orlin broke into Hussein's apartment to get his revenge. He wanted Hussein to experience the bitterness of life as he had experienced, not having a partner, not having a job, and getting sick because of an unhealthy lifestyle. The scene of this film then changed. It looks like Orlin doesn't want to live a careless lifestyle anymore. He seemed to be busy cleaning the apartment and changing his appearance by shaving his beard. He then began to dress neatly like Hussein. Now Orlin is ready to start his new life and find a job and his missing wife and child. Orlin then took out some breadcrumbs and fed the two pigeons. It turned out that the two pigeons were eating on top of a freezer. Unexpectedly, inside the freezer lay the body of Hussein, who Orlin had killed. This film also reaches its end when Orlin can take revenge for all that Hussein did to him.